waterfalls at Patalpani has fascinated and intrigued many over the years. But that is not what brings us here today, for running right past and within touching distance of the falls is one of the fast disappearing meter gauge railway lines of India. In 1870, the Maharaja of Indore, Savai Tukoji Rao Holkar II, commissioned the building of a line from Indore to the Great Indian Peninsula Railway main line at Khandwa. The line would climb the Vindhyachal Mountains by way of the Choral Valley to reach Indore. The section between Patalpani and Kalakund runs along the Choral River and, with its numerous bridges, viaducts and tunnels, forms a fascinating backdrop in which to view the operations of this 150 years old railway line. MAU stands for Military Headquarters of War, an acronym left over from the days of the British Raj. It is an ideal place to start our explorations of the line, as it is the northern terminus of the meter gauge route from MAU to Akola. The route stands isolated today, as the lines around it have all been converted to broad gauge. MAU was once a busy station along the meter gauge route from Ajmer to Akola, and its three platforms catered to the many trains serving the line. Today, a single platform caters to the remaining traffic, whilst the other platforms are undergoing reconstruction, waiting for the imminent arrival of the broad gauge trains from Indore. To the south of the station is an extensive carriage yard, as well as a diesel loco shed, which is home to 18 YDM-4 locomotives. Since this is an isolated meter gauge line, the shed is expected to carry out running repairs as well as periodic overhauls on the locomotives. In its heyday, the shed had an allocation of over 100 steam locomotives before steam services were withdrawn in 1998. Three rusting YP locomotives can still be seen lying abandoned in the shed, a standing testimony to the glorious days of steam. The next station on the line after MAU is Patalpani, significant in its importance as it is the start of the descent through the Choral Valley. Tourists visiting the nearby Patalpani waterfalls also disembark here, and the falls are only a short walk from the station. Even though we see some flat cars and tankers stabled here, barring some departmental trains, freight no longer runs on the line, and the only traffic the route sees are the 6 passenger trains in each direction. Safety is always a concern on the line due to its unique nature and difficult terrain, and a system of interlocking mechanisms ensure the safe running of the trains. Ravine Viaduct No. 2 is 120 meters long and rises about 50 meters from the valley floor, making it the highest bridge on the line. It was built in 1876 as a viaduct with two stone pillars, the demolished remains of which can still be seen here. In 1974, the alignment was changed and in its place stands today a five-span steel structure. Due to the sharp curves and steep 2.5% grade, it is mandatory for all trains to conduct brake tests while descending from Patalpani to Kalakund. Brake tests are done at four designated locations along the line and is a simple procedure which involves bringing the train to a complete stop and checking the brake pressure before proceeding again. The 100-meter-long Ravine Viaduct No. 1, built in 1876, still stands today on its original stone pillars, a testimony to the skill and durability of the railway builders of their time. Trains are not double-headed in this section, and the other locomotive seen here is actually a banker attached behind the lead loco. The banker will be shunted out at Kalakund and will later help train number 52964 uphill to Patalpani. The route does not see the heavy passenger loads as on most of the other sections of Indian Railways, but is sufficient enough to require the six pairs of daily trains. The railway runs through the densely forested areas of the Choral Valley and in the absence of any roads, the line serves as a roadway of sorts for the locals. Constant maintenance of the line is required to keep it running smoothly, and a sizable workforce is employed by the railways for its upkeep. A burning incense is mandatory to invoke the blessings of the gods and guarantees workflow smoothly and safely. Gangmen patrol the line daily and ensure the track is in good shape, all keys are in place, and any loose nut or bolt is tightened securely.
मेरा नाम विक्रम गिरवाल है। रोज पेट्रोलिंग करता हूँ, रोज पटरी चेक करता हूँ। 10 किलोमीटर के लिए कालाकुंड तक जाता हूँ और आता हूँ। अब
The permanent way inspector conducts routine inspections on his trolley and makes sure that there are no unauthorized or unsavory characters about the line.
Photography.
मतलब पर्सनल फोटोग्राफी कर रहे हो?
हाँ जी हाँ जी. The sleepy station of Kalakund lies at the bottom of the gradient of the Choral Valley. It is an important station on the line due to the fact that bankers are attached here to all uphill trains heading for Patalpani and Mau. An insight into the role and the importance of the bankers was provided to us by a pointsman at Kalakund.
My name is Lakshmi Narayan Kumari. San 80 se, matlab main yahan par nirantar service kar raha hu. Banker yahan par pehle हर गाड़ी में लगाए जाते हैं और वो इसलिए लगाए जाते हैं कि वैसे तो 220 टन लोड होता है पैसेंजर ट्रेन का और एक पावर ले जा सकता है लेकिन पैसेंजरों की सेफ्टी के लिए इसलिए कि कई कपलिंग अगर घाट सेक्शन में टूट जाता है तो फिर वो मतलब बहुत डेंजर कंडीशन आ जाएगी और गाड़ी मतलब गिर सकती है वहाँ से.
As YDM 4 number 6638, hauling train number 52964 from Khandwa, comes into Kalakund, it presents us an opportunity to view the operations of the bankers on the line. The 1350 horsepower Alco design YDM 4 number 6734 will perform the role of the helper today. It heads out to the south end of Kalakund station, where it will reverse and then back up to couple with train number 52964.
Thank you.
Today, the diesel motormen have life easy as they sit back and let technology do the hard work for them. Back in the days of steam, things were not that simple, and for the firemen, it was literally back-breaking work. At a maximum permissible speed of 25 km per hour, train 52992 from Khandwa finally conquers the 1 in 40 grade from Kalakund. The train has taken 30 minutes to cover the 10 km between Kalakund and Patalpani, helped in no mean terms by its banker, YDM4 number 6734. Upon coming to a halt at Patalpani, the loco detaches itself from the rake, which then continues on its way to Mau. Train 52992 is running about 15 minutes late today, and upon arrival at Mau, it will return back as train 52987. Once the train is clear of the platform block, the banker can then proceed downhill to Kalakund for its next assignment. About 1 kilometer downhill of Patalpani is a cat siding referred to by the locals as Tantia Mama. Tantia Mama was the local Robin Hood who took on the might of the British in the 1880s. A shrine is built here in his remembrance, and tradition requires that all downhill trains passing by seek its blessings for a safe passage. The banker finally reaches Kalakund, where it will wait to assist the next train bound uphill to Mau. The cycle will repeat itself 6 times in a day and for each of the 6 uphill trains. There are of course exceptions to every rule, and back at Patalpani, a complicated maneuver is underway when the locomotive of Akola bound train number 52975 picks up the banker which has just arrived on train number 52992 from Khandwa. This is done to save time as another Mau bound train was already at Kalakund. If one would have waited to release the banker after train number 52975 had left Patalpani, it would have resulted in a delay for the train already waiting at Kalakund. Upon arriving at Kalakund, the double-header detaches itself from its rake and the locos head out to the southern throat of the station where they decouple and then reverse back onto their respective trains. Soon it is time to depart and train number 52988 heads uphill to Mau while train number 52975 departs for Akola. We now head southeast towards the Narmada and the holy town of Omkareshwar. Omkareshwar is home to one of the 12 Jyotirling shrines holy to the Hindus, but that is not what draws us here, as spanning the Narmada at Omkareshwar is also an 850 meter long railway bridge which has been around since the last 140 years. Oh, Driving further south, we head towards Dhulghat. Dhulghat lies in the Melghat Tiger Reserve in Amravati district of Maharashtra, and the drive through the forest reserve was invigorating to say the least. The station itself lies in an isolated part of the forest and sees only 3 trains during daylight hours. About 2 kilometers southeast of the station lies a spiral which the locals refer to as Char Ka Ankda, or the figure of 4. This because the track plan of the spiral roughly represents the figure of 4 when written in Hindi. The spiral consists of a 16-span, 193-meter-long steel viaduct which spans a shallow valley. Trains coming from Akola cross the viaduct and, after completing a near 270-degree turn in about 4 minutes, passes below the first span of the viaduct before going on to Dhulghat. Mao-bound train number 52974 will cross Akola-bound train number 52973 at Dhulghat in a few minutes. The wait in between trains can get quite exasperating and requires a lot of patience and restraint on the part of the rail fan, for there is only that much one can do while waiting for the next train to show up. As train 52973 disappears into the forest on its way to Akola, we are left to ponder over our experiences of the line. With broad gauge conversion around the corner, one resigns themselves to the fact that the Char Ka Ankda spiral will soon be abandoned altogether, becoming just another chapter in a history book. The ghat section between Patalpani and Kalakund, with its 150-year-old history, would also form a prominent part of that chapter.